Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, Alpha, Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, you are worthy of our praise today, today, you are worthy of our praise today. Alléluia, Alpha, Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, Alpha, Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, you are worthy of our praise today, today, you are worthy of our praise today. Alléluia, Alpha, Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, Alpha, Alpha, Omega, Alléluia, you are worthy of our praise today, today, you are worthy of our praise today. Jehovah El Shaddai, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Chikenu, Jehovah Shammah, King of Kings, King of Glory, Lord of Hosts, the Lord Strong and Mighty, the Lord Mighty in Battle, the Lord who has never lost anyone before, Jesus, the Author, the Perfecter, the Finisher of our faith. We love you. We worship you. We celebrate your majesty. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for the gift of life. Thank you for your church. Thank you for our nations. Thank you for the whole world. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. Thank you, our Father and our God, for the month of June. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration. Glory be to your holy name. Good morning, Holy Spirit. We thank you for counting us even worthy to be part of Global Mission 2020. Discipleship, service, and prayer. Glory be to your holy name. We love you, Jesus. Good morning, Holy Spirit. For the next few minutes, do what is in your plan. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We thank God for the gift of life. I welcome you all in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Glory be to God. We thank God for how far He has brought us. As a nation, even the whole of Africa, we give Him praise. And the whole world, we celebrate His majesty for everything that He has done for us. Glory be to God. We bless the name of the Lord. You are all welcome. This is Global Mission 2020. This conference, this program is not a denominational program. It's for all believers, all Christians, everybody, everywhere, is permitted to be part of Global Mission 2020. Glory be to God. Jesus' mission must be our mission. That is the purpose for organizing this program. That we need to work as believers to depopulate hell and populate heaven to the glory of God. Hallelujah. So you are all welcome once again to be part of this divine agenda. Glory be to God. Believe strongly that your life is never, never going to be the same. We want to form, you want to organize, we want to raise an army, a great army for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Glory be to His holy name. So this morning, I want us to reflect briefly on the topic, mission. What is mission in this sense? Glory be to God. What is mission? And then we will discuss briefly, why did the Lord Jesus Christ even come to this earth at all? And why are you even here? Why are you alive and kicking by the special grace of God? Why are you here? We have to know the purpose of our living, of our existence. The Lord Jesus has brought us here for a purpose. The Almighty God made it possible that you should come to this world. So you are here for a purpose. We are on a mission, and we have to fulfill that mission and that purpose to the glory of God. Hallelujah. So our foundational scripture is Matthew chapter 28 verse 19. Matthew chapter 28 verse 19, that is where the Lord of God, the Lord Jesus Christ Himself, orders us, is ordering us, that say, that go and make disciples of all nations. Go and make disciples of all nations. It's not an optional issue here. It's highly obligatory. The Lord Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations. So you have to ask yourself, you are a preacher. You are a man of God. You are a prophet. Do you pursue Jesus' agenda, Jesus' mission, or you pursue personal interests? Glory be to God. Maybe concerned with regard to the recent lifting of ban, okay, allowing churches to go, okay, and fellowship at our various places of worship. Some of us may have hidden agenda while we have been itching, praying that the ban should be lifted. Is the purpose going to feed the children of God, the sheep of the Lord Jesus, to help them to be kingdom-minded? Are you going to prepare them for heaven, or because you have not been getting your offerings, your tithes? That is why you have been agitating, praying, and asking strongly that, oh, this ban must be lifted. We want to go to church. We want to go to church. We want to go to church. I pray that the Almighty God will preserve all churches, all believers, by the special grace of God, who are actually starting their Sunday services today. But please, don't have any personal interest. Don't pursue personal aggrandizement as a leader in the house of God. As a Christian, don't pursue personal interest. The mission, the agenda of the Lord Jesus must be your mission or agenda in life to the glory of God. So we'll go through briefly, and then we'll know the meaning of mission, biblical interpretations of mission. And then even when you go through the word, through even dictionaries, we have definitions for mission. So we'll go through various definitions, and then we will discuss, why did the Lord Jesus Christ even come to this earth at all? Why did the Lord Jesus Christ come to this earth at all? We'll go through that. And then we should know our mission, our purpose in life, and pursue that to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So, what is mission? Mission, the first meaning we should consider, that is a special assignment or assigned task. A special assignment, assigned task given to a person or a group to carry out. The Lord Jesus has given a special assignment. That is what is clearly stated or stipulated in Matthew 28, verse 19. We should, why Christianity at all? That is the whole issue. Why even religion at all? Why various denominations at all? Why are you a founder at all? You should know and believe that the Lord Jesus Christ himself said, go and make disciples of all nations. It's a task. He has given us a task. That is the mission. And this is a global mission, worldwide mission, purpose, not personal interest. Irrespective of whatever career that you pursue, whatever you do in this life, never forget to have divine purpose. Never forget, never hesitate to fulfill, to pursue divine purpose for your life as a child of God, as a believer. Glory be to God. So don't forget. And another meaning is a calling. It's a calling. In actual, I want to talk about mission. It's a calling, responsibility. The Lord has given us responsibility, a specific responsibility to show that. God has given you responsibility to show that wherever you find yourself, whether in academia, religious setting, political setting, wherever you are, the Lord has placed you there to fulfill or to show that responsibility, specific responsibility. Not personal interest. We have a lot of politicians, religious leaders, academic leaders pursuing personal interests, personal aggrandizement to the repent. Repent, my brother, my sister. Repent, Mr. Politician. Repent, Mr. President. Repent, Mr. Minister of State. And pursue the Lord Jesus Christ agenda and mission. Another definition for mission is diplomatic representation abroad. Diplomatic representation abroad. Diplomatic representation abroad. One thing we should know is that we are here as transient beings. We are visitors of this earth. That what you should bear in mind. So, you are here. It's like you have traveled abroad. Try to understand. You have traveled overseas. We have traveled overseas. This is not our permanent home. Ghana is not your permanent home. The whole of Africa, everywhere, wherever you are, your nation is not your permanent home, my brother, my sister. It's not your permanent home. It's scripture. So the Lord God Almighty is telling us when you read Hebrews, I think Hebrews chapter 13, verse 14 says, for here we do not have a continuing city, but we look out for the one that is to come. For here we do not have a permanent city, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 14, but we look out, we pursue the one that is to come. Is that what you have been pursuing as a believer, as a child of God, as a Christian, as a minister of the gospel? Is that what you have been pursuing? Is that what you have been pursuing? Do you know that you are here as a diplomatic representation for the Lord Jesus Christ? And then you are here representing like a delegation, a permanent diplomatic delegation in another country. In where? Another country. You are in a different country. Another country. You are not in your permanent home. That is what you should take note here. That the Lord Jesus Christ has sent us here for a purpose. We are here to represent him. We are here to pursue his mission as believers, as children of God, not to pursue personal interest. Not to pursue our personal interest. For here, we do not have a continuing city, but we look out for the one that is to come. That is to come. Continuing city, a town, a village, we don't have it, a permanent home here. But we should look out for the one that is to come. We must look out for the one that is to come as children of God, as believers. Glory be to God. That is what we need to know. And we read from, we can read even from P, glory be to God. Na ye nim kuro a ewo hoda yen na ye ni kuro a ewo hoda wo ha. Na mom de ebeba no achiri kwan na ye hwehwe. Glory be to God. It's all clear. I like this verse when I read the P. The one that is to come is the one we must look for. That is what we are looking for. That is the one we are pursuing. Is that the one you have been pursuing, my brother, my sister? Even for going to church today as a prophet, as a man of God, as a leader in the church, are you going even to pray for our nation, for the salvation of souls? Or you are thinking of the income, what you gain at the end of the day, the weekly allowance, the honorarium or the honoraria. You have been thinking about honoraria or honorarium. What you gain at the end of the service. Appreciation. That's what you have been thinking about. But have you been thinking about the soul that are perishing? Dying. That's what we have to pursue. As children of God. As believers. My brother, my sister. So don't forget. And then, another issue that we should know, that another definition that we have to consider as representatives of the Lord Jesus Christ, as ambassadors of the Lord Jesus, about mission. Another meaning of mission is that group of church workers. Group of all church workers. When you talk about mission, it can be considered a group of church workers. Group of church workers. Church workers, not church goers. No people who just go and warm the chairs. And at the end they go, they will dance. The all people think about is going to change even to dance, not about souls that are perishing. In actual fact, the Lord Jesus Christ did not ask us to go and sit in the church. I'm telling you, it's a meeting place. We have to go to church. We meet there to study, to empower ourselves, to be well equipped so that we can go out. So now the Lord Jesus is asking us to go out and preach, not to sit in the church, and we say we want to be in the church. I'm not against the Lord Jesus said we should not stop coming together, assembling as believers. I'm not against. I believe in that strongly. But the purpose of coming together as believers face to face is to study the word, to know the word of God, to get well equipped ministerially by the power and the fire of the Holy Ghost, so that you go out. So that you go out and reach the unreached for the Lord Jesus Christ. Not to sit down and warm the church, the chairs in the church or in the house of God. We must go. So the Lord Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations. This is an imperative statement. It's an obligation. Highly obligatory. Highly compulsory. It's not optional. They'll go and make disciples of all nations. Go and make disciples of all nations. But you decide always to be in the church. The Lord Jesus do not call us to sit in the church. He call us. That when you come together, we should study to know the word, to prepare, learn the techniques when it comes to evangelism, soul winning, discipleship, and at the end of the day, go out. Go out. Go out and reach the unreached. So these are the church workers. Church workers. So mission can be considered group of all church workers, not churchians. Not all. Churchians. We have churchians everywhere. And we have churchians everywhere. Churchians are people who go to church. They are not even Christians. They are not Christians. Because Christians behave like Christ. Have you been behaving like the Lord Jesus Christ? You claim you are a man, you claim you are a prophet, you claim you are an elder in the church. Do you really behave like the Lord Jesus Christ? Do you behave? Self-assessment. Scrutinize yourself. Assess yourself. That and know. And come out with your own result. Now, I know that I know the Lord Jesus Christ knows me. Glory be to God. So don't forget, you need to work for the Lord Jesus. Mission depicts, denotes church workers. So the Lord Jesus Christ himself said, when you read John chapter 9, verse 4, that as long as it is day, I must do the works of him that sent me, because night cometh when no man, nobody can do any work. My brother, my sister, as long as it is day, I must do the works of him that sent me, because night is coming when nobody, no one can do any work for the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the time you have to work for the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the time you must be man for the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the time you have to preach Jesus Christ and him crucified. This is the time, my brother, my sister. We need to preach Jesus and him crucified. Glory be to God. That is the purpose. That is the mission. Biblical mission. Biblical mission, not personal mission. Not religious mission. Biblical mission. Christian mission. Jesus said, I must do the work of him that sent me. Because night is coming where nobody, no one, no president, no minister of state, no doctor, no professor, no professor emeritus, no great scholar, no inventor, nobody. Nobody can do anything. Now that you are alive and kicking by the special grace of God, my brother, my sister, the Lord Jesus Christ is telling you, you must do the work of him that sent you. Let me read the Amplified Version. I like the Amplified Version so much. So let's read the Amplified Version. I've just quoted or paraphrased. The Amplified Version says, we must, John chapter 9 verse 4, we must work the works of him who sent me and be busy with his business daylight. Night is coming on. No man can work. We must work. So, mission, church workers, Christian workers, employees. Hallelujah. That is the meaning here. And the Lord Jesus is saying that we have to follow in his footsteps. Unless you say you are not a Christian, you are not a believer. If you are a believer, the Lord Jesus said that now this is why I am here. We must work. And he even made it a collective something. Now here, the we must. Why did he say we, not even I? All believers everywhere. Yes. We must work the ways of him who sent me and be busy with his business. Be busy with his business. The business of you busy with God's business with or with your own business. Are you busy? Have you been busy pursuing business? Kingdom promotion business? Oh, you have business. Yeah. Another key word you should want to take out there. He said, the one who sent me, somebody has sent us. That person did not come, try and understand this, the meaning of sent, the verb to send. When you send somebody, it's like you are not going there as a person. That is why it's pragmatically wrong, but not grammatically incorrect for somebody to say that I am sending my children to school. When it happens that that person is the driver, you are driving, taking the children, so you say, I'm sending my children. It's wrong. Yes, it means you are not going as a person. You send somebody when you are not going there as a person. Glory be to God. So the Lord Jesus is not here now, but he has sent us. The Almighty God has sent us. That is our mission, my brother, my sister. Try to understand this. Try to understand this. That the Lord Jesus has sent me, whoever you are. It's not about because you have titles, so. It's not because you have titles. Yes, that's what person. I don't like writing my title, Reverend. I don't normally write that. If you have observed, I don't like it, Pastor, Reverend. I just write my name. Yes. So that's secondary. That is mysterious function. But God has called me as a person, a human being, as Kwasi, as Adjoa, as a, God has called you, that you, whoever you are, whoever, God has called you. He called you by name. Not by titles. No, because, no. So, decide to work for Jesus, whoever you are. You can be a professor, you can be poor, you can be rich, you can be highly prosperous, you can live in affluence, whoever you are, you can be a child, you can be a man, a woman, irrespective of your status in life, my brother, my sister, the Lord Jesus has sent you. The Almighty God has sent us. And we are here to do his work. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God is good. All the time, God is good. I hope you are following to the glory of God. Now, about sending. Sending, we call it read John 17, verse 18, to know that God Almighty has sent us to this world, to this earth, as missionaries, as his workers, not as churchians. Not my church. You don't have any church. I don't have any church. A fellowship of a church by the grace of God. The church is you. The church is me. The church is the body of Christ all over the world. And that's what you need to pursue, my brother, my sister. Not denominations. Not denominationalism. No, my brother, my sister. The Lord Jesus has sent us. He gave us a universal assignment, mission. And you can read John 17, verse 18, to buttress the fact that the Lord Jesus has sent us. The Lord Jesus has really sent us to this world to fulfill his mission or agenda in life. Now let's read John chapter 17, verse 18. Glory be to God. The Lord Jesus, before he left this earth, this is what he said. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. John chapter 17, verse 18. Let's listen to the word of God. As thou, I'm reading from the Amplified, the King James Version, then I'll read the Amplified Version at the same time. As thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I also sent them into the world. Yes. Now, that's it. Sending. The Lord has sent us. Do you understand? God has sent you. Yes. The Lord Jesus Christ was sent by the King of Kings, the King of Glory, the Lord of Hosts. And you should not forget that. He said, I and my Father are one. By God himself. Jesus is God. So he came to this earth as man. He's 100% man, 100% God. That's what you should understand. One of these days, we go through Trinity so that you understand very well. Don't be confused, my brother, my sister. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So, let's read the Amplified Version as well. Just as, so clear, listen. The modern English here, just as you sent me into the world. He was praying to the King of Kings, the King of Glory, communicating, saying something. That my Father, my God, just as you sent me into this world, into the world, I also have sent them into the world. The Lord Jesus, wherever you are, know that the Lord Jesus has sent you there for a purpose. And the Lord Jesus has sent us as believers to this world to fulfill his agenda, mission, and purpose. For humanity, for mankind, for everybody, everywhere. That is it. That is the purpose. That is the reason. The Lord Jesus, you don't need to be ordained as a pastor, as a reverend minister, before you know that the Lord Jesus has sent you. No! 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 Once you are a believer, you are a Christian, the Lord Jesus has sent you. Go! Go, 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 go. Christianity is about going. It's about go. It's about go. It's about go. It's about go. And by the special grace of God, now we can preach everywhere through social media platforms. Okay? If face to face is impossible, what about sharing the gospel on televisions, on radio stations, and what have you? On Facebook, YouTube, glory be to God. You have access. We have no excuse than to share the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So the Lord Jesus has sent you. Know and believe. He is not here now, but we are representing him, just as I said. When you use the word sent, it means the person is not going as a person. I'm sending this to that person. I'm not going there. So never say, I am sending my children to school and then you are the driver. You go and drive. You have to say, I am taking my children to school. Pragmatically, that is correct. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. If you have not done linguistics and all that, you may not understand, but don't bother. We are just applying what we have studied small in school. Glory be to God. Amen. We bless the name of the Lord for how far he has brought us. I will conclude very soon. And don't forget, another definition of mission is that social responsibility. Social responsibility. Their faith is what? Social responsibility. A place that helps the needy by offering food, shelter, glory be to God, and spiritual assistance. Spiritual aid. When you talk about mission, mission can be considered as a place that offers, that helps the needy, the poor, by offering food, shelter, aid, or assistance, as well as spiritual comfort to needy people. When people come to church, now are they going to be fed, to be assisted? Are you going to help them, to empower them spiritually? That is it. I want to talk about mission. When you talk about mission, that's all we have to do. So it was about Christian, like social responsibility here as well. Christian social responsibility. Christian social responsibility. That is what in academia is considered as well. Service to community. Community service. In academia, let me tell you, I thank God for some of our my colleagues, lecturers, doctors, professors have joined. Glory be to God. God bless you all in the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you to continue to be a blessing in the name of the Lord Jesus. So we have service. Service to community. Community service. Before one can be promoted in academia, in a university setting, it's not about the publication. You need to publish papers very good. We need to all teach. But without service, without service, without service, without serving your community, that is something you do that is not for pay, that is not for salary. If anything at all, just honoraria, just honoraria, honorarium that will be offered. That's okay. If you don't balance that, you don't fulfill that condition, satisfy that condition, there is no way that you can be promoted in any university, particularly in Ghana. I don't know elsewhere. Glory be to God. So we are saying here that you are a Christian. You are a believer. You are born again. But please, please, please take care of the poor. The needy. The sick, the afflicted. Not come and exploit them. Somebody will come to church. The money, the only money the person may have on him or her is maybe 10 Ghana or 2 cedi. And they will say that, bring it now. And then you get Bible verses to also quote to support that. That's very good. But my brother, my sister, pastor, my colleague, pastor, reverend, minister, apostle, or whoever you may be, think about them. Think about them as well. Think about them. Have you ever decided that today, being the pastor, a leader in the church, I'm going to offer all the needy people, people who cannot fend for themselves, some food items? Have you ever done that before? My brother, my sister, have you ever done that before? All you think about is the pastor that must receive. Is the pastor that must be giving something. It's wrong. As a minister of the gospel, we need to balance it. We need to balance the equation. Glory be to God. False balance is an abomination unto the Lord Jesus. Glory be to God. So in scripture, Matthew 28 verse 31 through 46. When you read that, the Lord Jesus says something. That when I was hungry, did you feed me? When I was in prison, did you visit me? When I was thirsty, did you offer me a cup of water? What? Did you help me? I said, because you do not do that, say, go to hell. Hell is your place. Go, you are going to hell straight. For some of you, pastors, preachers of the gospel, that you'll be exploiting innocent people, the poor, the needy in the church. If you don't repent, the Lord Jesus Christ is saying, when you go read Matthew 25, verse 31 through 46, you will go to hell. If you are not careful, you will not make it. May God forbid that because of that you go to hell. May God have mercy upon you. Repent and start helping the poor, the needy in the society. So we want to balance it. We are not just thinking about just preaching. You preach Christ and Him crucified. But we need to preach the total gospel. We need to preach the total gospel. The complete gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So read it. Matthew 25 verse 31 to 46. That's what the Lord Jesus Christ was saying, all that. So it means that you can be a believer. You can be a preacher. You can be a very serious, committed Christian living in holiness, in righteousness as lifestyle. Without Christian social responsibility, helping the poor, the needy, you may not make it to heaven. That's what the word of God is saying. I am not saying it. Read it. When you go study it, Matthew 25, verse 31 through 40 say, consider the succeeding and the preceding text. Study that in context. Study that in context, not in isolation. And then you understand that you appreciate this. Glory be to God. And the Lord Jesus, I will read James, the brother of the Lord Jesus Christ, also says something. When you read James chapter 1, verse 27, I want to read that. James chapter 1, verse 27. Listen. Pure religion. James chapter 1, verse 27. He says something. Pure pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction, and to keep yourself and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Let me read the Amplified Version. Hallelujah. The Amplified Version says, external religious worship. External religious worship. So you can conflate this Christian social responsibility to be external religious worship. We have internal and external here. And external religious worship. Christianity here, you can think about external Christian worship or religion as it is expressed in outward acts, outward deeds. That is pure and unblemished in the sight of God the Father is this: to visit and help and care for the orphans and widows in their affliction and need, and to keep oneself unspotted and uncontaminated from this world. Hallelujah. God, this is so self-explanatory. So take care of the poor, the needy, the orphans. Take care of them. And the Lord God Almighty will bless you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Take care of the poor, the needy. In the wake of coronavirus pandemic, some people cannot even fend for themselves. You have an abundance. Have you been thinking about them? Have you been helping them? Maybe the church. All you think about as a pastor, as a minister of the gospel, is that the people are not bringing the offering these days. They are not paying their tithe. If you are also a church member by the special grace of God, be faithful and pay your tithes. Yes. Be faithful. Appreciate the ministers of the gospel. Your parents, your loved ones, if they need the poor, help them. Don't be selfish. Don't be self-seeking. Don't be self-opinionated. Don't pursue personal interest as a child of God. Glory be to God. You need to do that to the glory of God. And the Almighty God will bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus. In conclusion, Jesus' mission is our mission. What did the Lord Jesus Christ say? Why did he come to this world? Why did the Lord Jesus Christ come to this earth at all? Why did he come here? Why did the Lord Jesus Christ come to this earth at all? We'll go through the scripture briefly and then we'll call it a day. Glory be to God. Turn your Bibles to Luke chapter 19, verse 10. Luke chapter 19, verse 10. We are going to pray right now for the church, for our nation. The President of the Republic of Ghana has asked us all to pray for our nation. And we are going to pray for the whole world. Glory be to God. That the God of all grace and mercy will be merciful and gracious unto us all. And let COVID-19 pandemic disappear and die worldwide in the name of the Lord Jesus. For then, let's read Luke 19, verse 10 quickly. For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. That's the Amplified King James Version. The Amplified Version says, for the Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. That which was all lost. People who don't know Jesus. People who are dying and going to hell. You must go and look for them. Seek. He came to seek. Have you been seeking souls? That souls might be saved, or you have been seeking personal interest, seeking your own interest, or seeking to save souls, seeking, looking for, seek me to look for, to search. To search is like doing research. Glory be to God. Search and search again. Research it. Search and search. Research. You will search it again. Have you been searching for people? Have you been looking for souls to be saved? That is our agenda. That is the mission of our Lord Jesus. And Jesus' mission must be our mission all over the world, wherever you are. My brother, my sister, may the God Almighty bless you. May the King of Kings bless you. May the Lord of Hosts bless you. May the Lord Jesus, the author, the perfecter, the finisher of our faith, bless you. bless you to continue to be a blessing. And may the God of all grace give you more grace to pursue the mission of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And may the vision of the Lord Jesus Christ be your mission all the days of your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Give him praise. Give him glory. Give him honor. Give him adoration. Father, we love you. Father, we worship you. We celebrate your majesty for Global Mission 2020. We love you for your way. We thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your holy name. We celebrate you, Lord Jesus. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration. Glory be to your holy name. We love you, Jesus. We celebrate you, Jesus. You are worthy to be adored. You are worthy to be glorified. In Jesus' name. Now, my brother, my sister, wherever you are, if you don't know Jesus and you die today, you can't make it to heaven. We need to give your life to the Lord Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. John chapter 14, verse 6. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one, absolutely no one, can make it to heaven without the Lord Jesus. So you need to give your life to the Lord Jesus. The Lord Jesus is standing at the door of your heart right now, knocking. That my son, my daughter, open the door of your heart to me so that I will come and live in you and you will be with me forever and ever. If you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus, say, Dear Lord Jesus, today, I mention your own name, Michael Owusu Tabri. Dear Lord Jesus, I give you my spirit, my soul, and my body. Dear Lord Jesus, please have mercy on me. Save me today. Lord Jesus, I know I've been going wayward. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Save my soul today. And Lord Jesus, write my name in the book of life. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for saving me today. I am born again. I repent of my sins all the days of my life. I will live for Jesus. I will pursue Jesus' mission in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus, for saving me today. I love you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God bless you. In the name of Jesus, may the Holy Ghost empower you to serve Jesus as you have given your life to the Lord Jesus. May you never go back. May the Lord God Almighty give you more grace to serve the Lord Jesus. You need grace to serve him. May you receive that overflowing grace, abundant grace, great grace to serve the Lord all the days of your life. Be well rooted, be well grounded, be well consolidated in the Lord Jesus Christ. And may the agenda of Jesus Christ be your agenda all the days of your life. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We thank God. We bless the name of the Lord in the name of the Lord Jesus. Now let's pray for our nations. Wherever you are, let's pray for our nations. Wherever you hail from, wherever you come from, pray for your nation. We pray for our nations all over the world. We pray for Africa. We pray for Ghana in particular. We pray for Europe. We pray for Asia. We pray that, Father, you are the God of all grace and mercy. Father, be gracious and merciful unto the whole world. We might have gone wayward. We might have gone wayward. Lord Jesus, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Coronavirus, a lot of people might have been attributing it to 5G issue, attributing it to biological weapon here, whatever it is. We are pleading the blood of Jesus for mercy. Lord Jesus, have mercy. That's all that we need to pray. Oh Lord, have mercy on our nations. Have mercy on the whole world. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Lord Jesus, have mercy on our nations. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy on your church, Lord. Have mercy. Be gracious unto your church. In the name of Jesus, have mercy, have mercy, oh Lord, unto our leaders. Have mercy on the whole world, Lord Jesus. Have mercy on Ghana, have mercy on Africa, have mercy on Europe, have mercy on Asia, oh Lord Jesus. Have mercy on our nations, have mercy on our nations. In the month of June, Father, may we see the end of COVID-19 pandemic worldwide. In the name of the Lord Jesus, Father, this man, may we see the end. May we see the end. May we see the end of coronavirus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, have mercy, oh. Have mercy on our leaders. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy on on our academic leaders. Have mercy. Have mercy on our religious leaders. Have mercy on our political leaders all over the world. Lord Jesus, have mercy on our traditional leaders. Have mercy on our religious leaders. Have mercy on our political leaders. Have mercy on the masses. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy on the masses in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, have mercy. Glory be to God. Now, I want you to pray that, Father, Lord Jesus, Holy Ghost, empower me and fortify me so that your mission will be my mission all the days of my life. Lift up your voice and pray. That, Father, empower me by the power and the fire of the Holy Ghost so that I will pursue Jesus' mission. Jesus' mission will be my mission all the days of my life. Glory be to God. I want you to pray in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, help us. Lord God Almighty, help us, O Lord. Holy Spirit, fortify us. Strengthen us in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give us more grace, more grace, more grace, great grace to pursue your mission in the name of Jesus, not to pursue personal interests. Glory be to God. Father, give us more grace, more grace, more grace, more grace, Lord Jesus, to pursue your mission and vision all the days of our life. May the Holy Ghost empower you. May the strength of the Lord Jesus be upon you. May he fortify, may he strengthen you, and may he give you more grace to pursue the mission of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the mission of the Lord Jesus be your mission in Jesus' name. You are blessed. Stay empowered to the glory of God. Be blessed now and forevermore in the name of the Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. We love you all in the name of Jesus. This is Global Mission 2020. Our Sunday service, transformation service to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Global Mission 2020 is organized, glory be to God, spearheaded by Bethel Prayer Ministry International and by the special grace of God, the facilitator or main speaker for Global Mission 2020, discipleship, service, and prayer is Michael Osutebri. God bless you. I love you all. Goodbye. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.